could
give a couple of words of introduction to the Department of Management section. Blackpool is the largest seaside resort in Western Europe in terms of number of visitors. And by definition, management of the department reflects that organisation. We don't do chemical engineering or management associated with those sort of industries. We do management which is very much related to hospitality, hotel catering, tourism, four-year undergraduate honours degree programme with the Metro Polytechnic, which we run in partnership. Which
so you have the extra one in there?
Students actually from here do have quite a lot of success. We have had students who have appeared in the West End after being here. They go on television sometimes. The best students.
So what part of Darwin? Classic Darwin or?
It is more modern contemporary dance rather than traditional. But within sort of repertoire of drama skills. Windows and everything. If you go shopping, you go to a shop. Mm-hmm. Oh, can I help you? What would you like? Would you like to try this on? In a way, where's the project? Pass. Everyone's going to start somewhere. I may not be turning out for a band or a venue or something. Everyone develops themselves. Mm-hmm. So you try and create an environment where you can kind of train and move away from qualifications, national vocational qualifications, deal with clients, they sell goods. We have a hairdresser come in here, do the hairdressing, and the other side, beauty therapy, you know. The reason we've got this is for students to build confidence. If they're in trouble, we're always in the building, they can ask us for help. But otherwise, it's run by students for a whole week, and then at the end of the week, we change to new students and monitor their progress and see how good they've done, how bad they've done, and so on. But the idea is, we teach them hairdressing, we teach them beauty therapy.
Now, once students have completed this year's assessment, they can go on to a 2-year national and they learn about skills that are required of them, like answering the telephone, keeping documents, the skills of modern dancers, and they can take different options. They can look at marketing. Specified accounting, banking.
35 units in your course.
There are 35 different competences.
Yes, competences. And they will take about a month or three.
They can be done any time over the year. We have 4 teaching blocks throughout the year where specific competences are taught in that block. Now, if we don't press them at the time that we're teaching them, and giving and testing them, then they can come back to them at any time and try again.
I think it might be a tough job.
Yes. Could you actually go and get one of the files out this way?
Sono di fretta. Sì, sono di fretta. Ma la situazione è diversa, perché se dico...
Grazie.
Prego. Se dico...
The outside our department has to pay for the work that we're doing here. But it is important that the students get it right. What they're doing here, we have one girl here who's on reception this morning. The telephone here is the phone for the department, so any calls coming through to our department from outside or from inside the college, they come through here. So she answers the phone, redirects the calls, takes messages to staff and so on. She also greets people who come in and takes the work from them, finds out what they want. And she'll take it back to the telephone system if we have this round the corner. We run with 8 students normally. One girl from, or with one or two girls, not many, from each all-time course group. So they come in, not with their friends or people that they're on the course with, but from other people. So you get a whole range of levels in here.
And everybody came in for the first time. The member staff was in here all day. Now, because part of the level 3 MVQ is supervisory duty, we leave the level 3 girl in charge for part of the day now. So the staff is actually... I remember standing here for a test of how well she's running the units and how she wants to handle this problem, then I realise that she can't do it very well. Or if she cares very well, then she can find off to do it. But Claire is our supervisor this morning. She's a second year student, so she had one week last year, Claire. Just 1 week. If they need any information, then if they have some feeling of recognition for what they have to do. And they actually, if you do it there to the rest of the group,
and they're not in the workshop all the time. How many hours of workshop do you have? 11? They have 11 hours in this room. But they do have 6 weeks outside on work placement. They all go to the training unit and they all go to the college mail room to actually handle our mail for the college and to the college print room to do the photocopy of the graphics job. Plus they go out into the and the simulation is better here. We try to put more responsibility on the students and to do more realistic work. So as they're doing stock there for the simulator for their group, we actually run the stationery department for our department. So any stationery stuff we order and then we deliver it out and so on. We keep the record if we can. Because I think they learn better that way. Especially at this level, because they're quite bright, so they can soon put it. Some of the girls actually just been this morning. A member of staff's got a filing system which is terrible. She said she's got 2 filing cabinets which are all need sorting out. So as part of their course, they're going to reorganise that for them. So I'm sure they must be here. Or the department, 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 or the department
May.
Apparently Mr. Bannister's meeting you here, isn't he?
Good morning.
Dear boy, sir.
Yeah, how are you?
There, boy. Have the bless of
me.
I call my boss up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm
there. Go ahead.
It usually starts off at about 26 and then begins to be dropping out. And in this country, I don't know what it's like in Sweden, but in this country the employment is pretty desperate. So that anybody at the top of the job almost certainly takes it, which means good students because they can get work. So we might start off say at about 26, that's the information, and drop down to about 18. I'm talking mainly about the students of the age group 16 to 19.
There was a phase about 10 years ago of building these things. I don't know, before that we used to have big benches right across, and then they decided they wanted these island benches. They work okay, you know, they're not bad. I used to teach physics many years ago, but not anymore, thank goodness. Yeah.
And what we've got is very greatly with emphasis in business studies at the present time.
Yes.
And languages are beginning to become more important. Mm-hmm. But what you might call the linear subjects, mathematics, chemistry, physics,
physics, things like that, because they tend to depend upon previous knowledge of attainment, they tend not to be up to the ones that want to. We have difficulty with them. And the Institute of Physics, which is the UK sort of physics association, has noted a terrific decline in the number of institutes that are not doing physics. Even at university level, they're closing. Whereas when I went to university many, many years ago, physics was the subject, even in physics, everybody was keen on that. And if I go along with it, we've seen it in another room, we've got one this day.
Sweden, Doris. I've been staying here about a week, and Good training, did it? No, I wanted a good training. Have a go again. Yeah, we're both in here. I think you've got a cold, so all 10. So you can keep your MLF letter there, you should be able to keep all your names or your documents.
Yeah,
I don't know,
you
might need to. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that's N. So N is the log, you know, Pat.
Yeah.
Once you finish reading, that's it. Once you press return, company decided to put computers into every college. And they had a competition, and from that competition they decided that the BBC was going to be the one. And this was made by the BBC television and radio company. And the concept was that every school would have one of these. At least one. Throughout the country. They're not very good systems. They're very small. When they first came out, they were very good. They were 32Ks, and that was the biggest thing you could do, and they were superb. But what they've done, they've progressed a long time now. Very easy to use. Extremely easy to use. And the basic thing was about there's a lot of basic programs for teaching young people how to operate computers.
Yeah.
Now, this is a touchscreen for people who have either got mouse sticks or head sticks, so they don't have to touch anything. So it's a straightforward touchscreen system, but an extremely cheap touchscreen system, where most touchscreen systems are quite expensive. This is a fairly cheap one. And this one will bring up a series of words, and you've got to make sure which word a word goes. It helps you to climb. It's a ladder. So you move them around. There's lots of different ones. You can change to white on black or black on white, whichever you wish. Some people prefer it that way around. You can focus it up. And so to read your books, you can read your books. It's just a straightforward camera. I can have a camera view doing the same thing in a sense. So it's you doing the same thing. So it's just straightforward. It's a pinch of television camera, that's all. And these are just simple keyboards which can plug into the system. So you can use them or you can use your toe. The keyboard's optimised so you've got the best keys. It's not like a QWERTY keyboard. It's the most usable keys in certain areas. So you can get to them quicker. And you put these anywhere you like. You know. Say this keyboard here. A similar keyboard, you can make it any size you like. So you take that out and you put another keyboard of any size you want. So it can be just two squares or it can be just each individual square, 128 different keys.
But can they do them by themselves or do they have to...
I'll show you that when the Kinect comes up.
Okay.
Can you put the Kinect in there as well? We'll put this into the Kinect.
And what is this little keyboard?
Well, this one is the same as that one, exactly the same as that one. But it's for people with a very small amount of movement, so they can just move it with a small mouse stick, or they've only got a small sort of hand system. Yeah, any system you like in that respect. So these two are exactly the same keyboard. Just it's a variation of the movement that you can actually achieve with that movement itself. I can operate it by, and on the screen there will come a keyboard. Yeah. I can now move that keyboard down. I can speed the scanning up. Good luck, start moving it down to where I want it to be. Yeah. Okay. And then if I wanted to get something, I can use my mouth. I can use a. I don't want to see it actually. It's going to cross. This is now going across the top of the screen.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or if I want to go across this one here, I'm going to this one here. It'll now scan across here and bring, as it comes, bring each of my choices down. So I can go down to a choice. I can now go down. And it'll now open my screen for me.
Yeah.
Look at it.
Yeah, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Let's move the sound up a bit, I think, so you can hear it. So it's the same thing on that. If I don't like that, I can actually change it to Morse code. And there are, I can have different types of keyboards. That the King and the Mini King are these here. These small keyboards are things. I can go into Morse code if I wanted to. So Morse code is very good because if a person is only using a switch, any switch, whether it's a tap switch, a head switch, knock switch this way, or I've got little eyes, little switches down here, the eye switch, the small eye switch. Right. So people can write quick. Yeah. If you're just a switch user, you can actually write quicker by using Morse code. So why go through alphabets and scanning screens? Why not use Morse code? It's another language. I can design the Morse code keyboard. I can actually design it if I wanted to. Sorry. I would just scan the keyboard and pocket a card if I wanted to. Very lightly touch it and that will work. That one's the same. We've got little switches here that you can put on your glasses when you blink. Or you move your eye left and right. There's a difference between the white of the eye and the dark of the eye to determine that there's a movement. We're designing one now that puts on your teeth. Because if you think about it, if you're disabled, the one thing you must be able to control is your tongue, otherwise you die, you fall back in your mouth. So you put a little switch on your teeth there, like a tooth cap. And you can do it that way. And that's just another system.
Yeah.
I thought I was happy for that. But that one I've had one has to be an end.
And serial one,
That's it?
Yeah.